Good afternoon. In this lecture, we will discuss anticonvulsant drugs and their classification. The anticonvulsants are also termed as anti-epileptic drugs and anti-seizure drugs that are used invariably in the adequate and impressive control and management of CNS disorder, essentially characterized by recurrent transient attacks of disturbed brain function, which ultimately give rise to motor, sensory and psychic sequence of events. If we see the mechanism of action of an anticonvulsant drug, these drugs inhibit seizures by potentiation of synaptic inhibition through an action on the GABA receptor. These agents increase GABA receptor mediated current by increasing the duration of burst of current without changing their frequency. They have stimulatory action on the GABA channel in the CNS by elevation of the inhibitory action of GABA. The anticonvulsant therapy mediated by this drug is through different aspects of neurotransmission inhibition in the brain. Let's see some examples of drug having different mechanism, like by inhibiting sodium channel. By inhibiting sodium channel, the phenytoin works by inhibiting sodium channel. Similarly, other drugs, vigabatrin and valproate, benzodiazepine derivatives, have different mechanism. Second, by inhibiting GABA transaminase enzymes, vigabatrin. By inhibition of T-type calcium current, examples, valproate. These drugs inhibit by different mechanism. By GABA agonist activity, like benzodiazepine derivative works by GABA agonist activity, means they increase the agonist activities. Next is the classification of the anticonvulsant drugs. These are classified in the following way. The first is barbiturates derivatives. Second, hydantoins derivative. Third, oxazolidine dione derivatives, succinamide, phenylacetylurea, benzodiazepine derivative, carbonic anhydrase inhibitors, GABA analog, immunostilbenes, and miscellaneous drugs. In previous lecture, we have already discussed about the barbiturates and their derivatives in the topic of sedative and hypnotics, and also in antipsychotic drugs. There are the derivatives of barbiturates, which has the activities of anticonvulsant. Most of the barbiturates are sedative and hypnotics. We know that only a few of them shows anticonvulsant character. Three important barbiturates that show anticonvulsant properties. The examples are phenobarbital, mefobarbital, and metharbarbital. These drugs are obtained by the substitution in the basic skeleton of barbiturate at R' position, R5 position and R-5 position. These are the substituents here given in the table. By substituting this substituent at this position, these drugs are obtained and has anticonvulsant activity. Similarly, hydantoin derivatives. Hydantoins are close structure relatives of barbituric acid, differing due to the lack of C6 oxo group. The lack of this carbonyl group decreases the acidity, so it is a weaker acid than that of barbiturate. So hydantoin derivatives are obtained by the substitution in the basic skeleton of hydantoin at R3 position, R5 position and R-5 position by using the substituent. The examples of anticonvulsant of head entoin derivatives are phenytoin, most commonly used drug in the epilepsy, phenyl ethyl head entoin, mephenytoin, ethotoin. These are the drugs which are obtained by the different substitution at this position in the head entoin skeleton. Next is oxazolidine ion derivatives. The replacement of NH group at position 1 of the head entoin system with oxygen atoms yield the oxazolidine 2,4-dione system. Let's see. In the basic skeleton of oxazolidine dione, these are the drugs which are obtained by this substitution having anticonvulsant activity. Examples are trimethadione, also known as troxidone, paramethadione, malidione, dimidone. These are the examples of derivatives of oxazolidine dione which has activity of anticonvulsant and are obtained by the substitution at R3 and R5 and R5' position by the substituent. Next is succinamide derivative. Similarly, the succinamide derivatives are obtained by the substitution in the basic skeleton of this succinamide by the substituent at R1 position, R3 position and R3' position. Examples of succinamide derivatives having anticonvulsant activities are fensuximide, methsuximide, ethosuximide. These are the examples of succinamide derivative having anticonvulsant activities and are obtained by the substitution in the basic skeleton of succinamide at R1, R3 and R3' position. Next is acetylurea derivatives or phenylacetylurea. Examples: phenacetamide, phenylethyl acetylurea. Next is very important drug, benzodiazepine derivatives. We have already discussed the benzodiazepine derivative in the previous lectures having the antipsychotic activities. Here there are two examples of benzodiazepine having anticonvulsant activities. Examples are nitazepam, clonazepam. Next is carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. Examples: acetazolamide, ethoxazolamide and sulthiamine. Next is GABA analogs or gamma aminobutyric acid analogs having anticonvulsant activities. Examples are progabide, vigabatrin, tiagabin, gabapentin. Next, immunostilbins. Example: carbamazepine, and in miscellaneous, sodium valproate, primidone. So these are the examples of anticonvulsant drug in the different following categories. Thank you. In next lecture, we will continue the synthesis of some selected drugs and structure activity relationships of anticonvulsant drugs.